Have you ever wondered what it's really like to be a software architect? Let me take you behind the scenes of my career, from the adrenaline rush of solving complex problems to the satisfaction of mentoring the next generation of engineers and the wisdom I would pass on to my younger self. I'll share the milestones, the lesson learned, and the non-technical skills that have been game changers. So grab a seat and get ready to a candid look at the world of software architecture. What do I do? What's on my business card? On my business card, you will find the title Software Architect, Google Developer Expert in Angular, and Content Creator. But what do I actually do? Well, it's a mix of full-stack development, software architecture, mentoring and coaching, writing online articles, and producing videos for my YouTube channel and Udemy video courses. It's a diverse and fulfilling portfolio that keeps me engaged and constantly learning. How did I get there? What were the most important cornerstones along the way? Getting here has been a long and winding journey. I began my career as a software engineer back in 2006. Those early days were a blend of excitement and challenge as I navigated the complexities of the field. A significant milestone was in 2014 when I published my first public article in Java magazine. This was a pivotal moment that sparked my passion for sharing knowledge. In 2018, I ventured into publishing online articles on Medium. This platform allowed me to reach a broader audience and refine my voice as a content creator. Then came 2021, a year of firsts. I published my first video on YouTube and delivered my first public talk at the NTGS conference. These experiences were both exhilarating and terrifying, pushing me out of my comfort zone and helping me to grow. Today, I delivered 8 public talks and appeared in 4 podcasts. Reflecting on my journey, I realized the most important cornerstones were my personal growth and overcoming my shyness. Improving my communication, self-confidence, and assertiveness has been crucial. My drive to create content and engage in public speaking stems from a desire to connect with a global audience and contribute to the tech community. What first drew me to the IT field? From a young age, I was fascinated by astronomy, mathematics, and psychology. However, the path to becoming an astronaut and working at NASA seemed unclear, and the job market for psychologists in Tunisia wasn't promising. So I shifted my focus to computer engineering, a field that promised both demand and financial stability, which was a practical choice that aligned with both my interests and goals. Despite the pressure and challenges of being a software engineer, I find immense satisfaction in my work. The ability to gather and share knowledge and to make an impact to the tech community brings me great pride. The journey hasn't always been easy, but it's been incredibly rewarding. What role does software architecture play in my professional life? Software architecture is one of the most captivating aspects of my job. It's like a vast, ever-evolving landscape where there is always something new to explore and learn. What excites me the most is the opportunity to practice creativity in a field that remains relevant for a long time. Unlike programming languages and frameworks that get updated frequently, the principles of software architecture stays valuable for years, sometimes even decades. If I create an article or video about a new feature in TypeScript 5 or 4 or Angular 18, it might be a hot topic today, but next year it could be outdated. However, software design patterns and architectural styles maintain their relevance for a longer time. Diving into software architecture also requires a different mental approach compared to deep coding. It's about zooming out to see the big picture, understanding system thinking, and connecting the dots between the business side and technical details. It's about asking why behind each architectural decision and being proactive to anticipate future changes. Moreover, software architecture isn't just about end users. It's also about the developers. As architects, we need to consider both user experience, UX, and developer experience, DX. By leveraging feedback from developers, we can continually evolve and optimize the architecture. This not only improves the system, but also helps us understand and mitigate our biases as architects. To sum it up, software architecture allows me to blend creativity with strategic thinking. It's a dynamic and fulfilling field that keeps me engaged and constantly learning. What's the most non-technical skill that has helped me in my career? Three non-technical skills stand out as crucial to my career growth. Learning from failures and mistakes, committing to continuous learning, and improving my soft skills. Each time I stumbled, I learned to see it as an opportunity to grow. This mindset has been invaluable, turning setbacks into stepping stones. My commitment to continuous learning has kept me adaptable in a fast-paced industry, while honing my soft skills has enhanced my ability to communicate, lead, and collaborate effectively. What professional goals am I currently focused on? Currently, my professional goals are centered around growth and impact. I aim to expand my presence as a content creator, Udemy course instructor, and speaker. Building a larger, more engaged community is a key focus, as I want to share my knowledge and make a meaningful difference in the tech world. Ultimately, I aspire to become a thought leader in both technology and leadership, guiding others and influencing the industry with my insights and experiences. What are the limitations of my job? One of the main limitations of my job is the relentless speed of technological change. Staying up to date and maintaining a clear vision of the big picture can be challenging. At times, it feels like being a small cog in a massive machine, uncertain where it leads or what shape it will take next. This can be overwhelming, but it also drives me to continuously learn and adapt, ensuring I remain confident and competent in navigating this ever-evolving landscape. Three pieces of advice for my 18-year-old self. Embrace the challenges. Tough times are inevitable, but they are also opportunities for growth. Facing and overcoming them will make you stronger and more resilient. Learn from every experience. Every mistake and failure is a lesson in disguise. Reflect on them, understand what went wrong, and use that knowledge to improve. Keep moving forward. Persistence is key. No matter how difficult things get, keep pushing forward. Your efforts will pay off, leading you to greater success. The path of software architect is filled with both challenges and rewards. It requires a blend of technical know-how, creative thinking, and strategic vision. It's a role that keeps you on your toes, constantly learning and adapting to the ever-evolving tech landscape. Reflecting on my career, I realized that the most valuable lessons often come from unexpected places, being a late-night coding session gone awry, or a moment of clarity during a team brainstorming session. Embracing these moments, learning from them, and using them to fuel your growth is what truly defines a successful career. So whether you are just starting out or you are a seasoned professional, remember that every experience is a stepping stone. Stay curious, stay passionate, and most importantly, stay connected with the community. After all, it's the shared knowledge and collective wisdom that propel us forward. Keep pushing the boundaries, and who knows? You might just find yourself creating the next big thing. Excited about diving deeper into the world of software architecture? This video is just the beginning. Check out my Udemy video course on software architecture, where I explore these concepts further and dive into real-world challenges. The link to the course is in the video description below. And here is a bonus. Subscribe to my newsletter and you will get free access to all my courses. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more updates and tech insights. See you next time.